So today what I'm going to be showing you is how to remove the front bumper cover on this Dodge Durango. In case you need to do any kind of body repair to replace this, or if you need to get behind it to get to anything such as headlamp assembly or grill itself. I'll show you step by step what you need to do to get this off. So with the vehicle up in the air, now we can get access to the fasteners that hold the front bumper cover to the vehicle. Now we got a combination of two 10 millimeters on the outer edges, and we got a total of three quarter turn fasteners that you just turn and then pull off. Now of course, this vehicle being damaged, it's missing some of them. So we'll go ahead and get the 10s off and what fasteners we do have, quarter turn, and we'll get them off. This is one of the three quarter turns. You'll just grab it, twist it, and pull it off. It's just rectangle shape going up in there. And of course, this is the other 10 millimeter. So a total of two of these and three of these you'll take loose. Now, removal of the tire is not necessary. I only took it off so that I could get you some better angles with the camera so you can see everything. All you need to do while it's on the ground is turn your steering wheel all the way to the left or to the right, whichever one, depending on what side you're working on, to get you a little more access to the fasteners on the front end. Otherwise, like I said, I only took it off to help you see. You don't need to. Now, so that you don't cause damage to the painted surface on this fender flare right here in the front bumper cover area, I recommend taking it off. Now, it just snaps around the perimeter, and then right up here where it mounts to the actual front bumper cover, they would normally be two plastic rivets, and those you would knock the center pins out, or you would actually drill the centers out. This one being, like I mentioned, had previous repairs done. It's got Christmas tree fasteners, so I'll be taking those out. Otherwise, it just unsnaps. Otherwise, the problem you might have is, as you're trying to get the bumper cover back on, fender flares hanging here, there may be some contact, may get some scratches. It's best to be safe and take it off. If any of the plastic snaps come unloose and stay attached to the fender, you can pop them off and reattach them to the fender flare. If they break, you're definitely going to need to replace them. That way it stays on like it's supposed to. So this is where the plastic rivets would normally be. Like I mentioned, they put Christmas tree fasteners. Try to go back with the plastic rivets if you can. They hold on a lot better. We'll go ahead and pop these off. And then I've got two more fasteners. I've got an 8mm down below and a 10mm up here. And that would be the liner attaching to the front bumper cover. All right, so the fasteners are off on the front edge going to the front bumper cover. I'm just gonna go ahead and grab this and start pulling outward. Take your time. You shouldn't have to use any trim sticks. You should be able to do most of this by hand. Like I said, they are plastic snaps. They can be on there and it may take a little bit of force. You're not trying to damage it. You're not trying to break it. You're not trying to be rough, but you got to get it off because they're snapped on. So just work it around. And there we go. Bottom one did stay on. We'll take that off and we'll put it on the back side. So these are the little plastic snaps that hold it in place. Around the front edge, you don't have any. But on the rest of it, you do. And this one will be reinstalling. Otherwise, around the perimeter is what you're gonna be looking for. You can see where this one's been broken. Someone's actually used some JB Weld to actually put it back on. So when you're taking things apart, if they break, sometimes it's not your fault. Sometimes it's been broke before. This one's still holding, but that's another repair that someone did instead of replacing the assembly. There's a bottom 8mm, attaches that fabric type fender well liner to the front bumper cover, and then we'll move up to 10. And our 10mm. So with that upper 10mm out, we pull it back. You actually see there's a piece that's sticking through. There's a threaded stud that sticks through. Now, if you grab the front bumper cover and you pull back and out and off, it releases it. That actually helps hold it in place. So if you go back, we would definitely make sure that you snap it over that and then snap around the perimeter as well. But once you release this side, you've now got everything on the fender well liner taken loose, and now we can actually work on getting it off. Now, once we got that fender well liner unbolted from the front bumper cover, And before we take the front bumper cover off, we need to make sure that there's nothing plugged in, such as the fog light. On the fog light, all you gotta do is reach in here, grab the connector, squeeze, pull it off. And we'll repeat the same thing on the driver's side. Right here where the front bumper cover meets the fender, there's a plastic mechanism up under here that everything snaps into. When you get the front bumper cover loose and you're pulling it around, it unsnapped. Also, when you're going back with it, you gotta line it up and give it some gentle taps to line it. What would probably help at this point is to put some tape on right here, because as we're going back, once again, we don't want to scratch the actual paint on the vehicle. I'm just grabbing some body shop paint, something that's not gonna stick that great as far as permanently, leave marks or sticky stuff all over it. Put a couple pieces, and that should be enough to stop me from actually scratching the front bumper cover. I'm just trying to make sure it looks the way it came in when it leaves. Alright, so up underneath we've gotten all the fasteners taken loose. We got the fasteners inside the fender well opening as well, and we've got it unsnapped from the front fender right here. Now we're just going to work our way around. There's some areas where it's going to snap in right here around the headlight. We're just going to work it around. Now keep in mind, the grill stays on the vehicle, does not come off with the front bumper cover. And also, we did unplug the fog lights. So just grab an edge, start working it. Now, you may take a little force. Like I said, I'm not trying to break it, I'm not trying to be rough, but I've got to unsnap it, and there's no easy way to do it. So work your way around. Grab it and sit it off to the side. So here's the area that the front bumper cover goes around the headlight. Right here is where it snaps in place as well. And you got your fingers that go right up under the grill every so often. And when you're going back with it, make sure you give it a couple of gentle taps. Just gentle enough to snap it back in place. Make sure everything is firmly seated. Now when you're going back with the front fascia or front bumper cover, whatever you want to call it, the installation is just opposite of removal. Just follow the steps, you won't have any problems. There's no snags or any kind of secret tricks. It's exactly just the opposite of how we removed it. So definitely take your time and you shouldn't have any problems. And make sure you don't do any kind of scratching, anything painted. Like I said, if you need to put your tape on the side, so be it. Just take your time, and if you need someone to help you, get someone to help you. So at this point, this is where I ask for any kind of thumbs up on YouTube. Don't forget, you can like me on Facebook. You can check me out on Instagram and Twitter as well. And if you got any comments or suggestions about the video on this Dodge Durango today, or anything Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, or Ram related, please feel free to email me at david@motorcitymechanic.com, and I will try to get back to you in a timely manner. Once again, thanks for watching these videos.